So Bismillah, Alhamdulillah, Salatu Salam ala Rasulillah. All praise due to Allah, whom we seek His help, we seek His forgiveness and mercy. Blessings be upon our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Respected brothers, still Subhanallah, from long time we didn't talk about the signs of the hour. And to be honest with you, we're just finishing the minor signs of the hour, and I believe the next halaqa could be the major signs of the hour. And just one sign of the hour that we will inshallah talk about, or we spoke about it, and I just would like to remind you that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about that there will be no mountains in, you know, the Arabian Peninsula. And what Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam meant in Mecca, you can say in Mecca or Medina. And this is what exactly nowadays you can witness if you're going to Mecca or Medina, especially Mecca, and also if you go through the channels, you look into the channels, you will see the instructions going on. So they are, mashallah, digging holes and tunnels inside the mountains, and you will see roads. And nowadays, mashallah, they are working on the trains and everything, and it's going through all these, you know, big giant mountains. So this is one of the things that Prophet ﷺ mentioned in a hadith, and we spoke about it. Now, one of the signs of the hour is, the Shaykh is mentioning here, لَا تَقُمُ سَاعَةً حَتَّى يُدْرَسَ الْإِسْلَامِ. Yudras means yamhu, which is the time will come that the Islam will vanish, you know, from the people's heart and people's chest. And another sign, he is mentioning two signs here, رَفْعُ الْقُرْآنِ مِنَ الْمَصَاحِفِ وَالصُّدُورِ, that Quran will be lifted up from the masahif, from the books, and from the chest, from the, you know, hearts of the people. And the hadith here, it says, عن حذيفة رضي الله عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال يدرس الإسلام كما يدرس وشيو ثوب حتى لا يدري أو يدرى عن ما الصيام ولا الصلاة ولا النسك ولا الصدقة ويسري على كتاب في ليلة فلا يبقى في الأرض منه آية تبقى وتبقى طوائف من الناس الشيخ الكبير والعجوز يقولون أدركنا آباءنا على الكلمة لا إله إلا الله فنحن نقولها. سبحان الله, it's a very scary hadith, and it's an authentic hadith as well. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said the Islam will lift out, and Islam will vanish as you try to remove and vanish the spot from your own thobe, from your own, you know, clothes. If you have a spot or something like that and you would like to remove it. And this is what exactly happened nowadays. If you see, you know, all, subhanAllah, the enemies of Islam, from somehow, somewhere, they're trying. And recently, Brother Faraz sent this, the link. It says that, you know, people are forced to do something haram, you know. So in I think France, right, I believe, in one of the shops in France, it's a Muslim man selling grocery. So the local authority forcing him to sell alcohol and pork, and if you don't want to sell it, we will shut down your, you know, things, you know. So imagine. So in other way, they are trying to remove Islam as much as possible, you know, because khalas, if you open this door for this guy, you know, forcefully, okay, maybe he will not be satisfied, maybe not, he will be not comfortable, but maybe time after time after time, for him it will be fine. Okay, the money is coming from alcohol, the money is coming from pork, or the money is coming from the halal product, it doesn't matter, it's all, you know, money. So this is one of the things, and this is only one small, you can say, place or a subject that we are talking about. Islam is, you know, people are fighting Islam from long time, and nowadays it's more open, subhanAllah. And just a few days back, I went through some persons doing a social experiment in the States, going into the street and putting the rug, the mat, and making salah, you know, in front of the people. So people are looking, people are, you know, if they see this person is making salah, they will just, you know, move, you know, afraid maybe. Some other people, you know, this is what I'm, you will find three categories of people. Some people, they just see and do nothing. Some people see and walk away. Four categories of people. Some people see and ask, and some people see and make a joke out of it, you know. So what I'm talking about, the one who will see and then come and talk. Those who saw this incident that this person is making salah, praying in open places, they will come and they will see, well, what are you doing? So the person is saying, well, I'm praying to God. Said, yeah, but you know, just I would like to know, we heard always that, you know, Islam is terrorist and something like that. So is it related to your, you know, religion, or is it related to your, you know, practice? So the person said, no, it's not like that. Every single person who came to talk to this guy, he was saying the same thing. Which means that, you know, everyone almost, you know, brainwashed completely. They don't know what's going on. And if they know that if this person is Muslim, link it to terrorist and ISIS and whatsoever. So subhanAllah, so this is what I'm saying, that the Prophet ﷺ said that people will try to remove Islam as you try to remove the spot, you know, the dirt from your clothes, number one. And then the Prophet ﷺ said, until the people will not know what is salah, what is siyam, and what is sadaqah. Imagine it to that extent. You know, today, yes, we pray, and some people pray as a habit. Some people pray because, you know, they saw their fathers praying. But imagine, we will reach into the extent that people will not know what is salah, what is sadaqah, what is fasting, you know. The ulama here said another different opinion, that yes, they will pray, they will fast, they will give sadaqah, but they don't know why they are doing it, you know. They don't know the purpose of it, you know, they're just doing it. And then Prophet ﷺ continued, and he said that you will find a sheikh, an old person, will talk to his kids that, you know, we don't know except that we saw our fathers saying La ilaha illallah, and we are just repeating this. And who's saying this? The Prophet ﷺ said, an old man saying to his, you know, children and grandchildren that I saw my father and my forefathers saying La ilaha illallah, so I'm just saying it. So imagine, he is almost old, 50, 60, 70, 80 years old whatsoever, you know, and he is telling his, you know, progeny, which means that, you know, they will try to vanish the Islam, or the at least the essence of the Islam, the understanding of Islam will be completely away from the people. And also here there's a hadith which talks about the same thing, about the removing the salah and siyam and everything. And the Prophet ﷺ also said here in a hadith that the Quran will lift out, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which means that people will not follow the Quran, the teachings of the Quran, and the time will come that even people will not consider the Quran as anything, as something important. So they will just leave it, they will just, you know, abandon it. And this is almost, you know, we are living into this state and this time, that the Quran, people will not value the Quran. Few other points that I would like to mention, actually this is, as I told you, at the end will happen, and subhanAllah. The Prophet ﷺ here said that the time will come that the Kaaba will be into pieces. A person will break Kaaba into pieces, hajaran hajara. That, you know, people will really make a small stone out of the whole Kaaba. And we know the Kaaba is a sacred place, the whole Kaaba is a sacred, and subhanAllah. And the Prophet ﷺ, into extent, he said that the one who will break it, he will be from Habasha. And the scholar nowadays, they focused on Habasha, where exactly, and they said it will be from Ethiopia nowadays, you know. You know, we have maids from Ethiopia, we bring maids, and a lot of cases happening from these maids. Of course, we cannot say the whole country is like that, but, you know, the maids are killing, you know, attacking either the owner of the house, or, you know, the kids at home and whatsoever. So one of the person was, subhanAllah, he did a study, research, and he said, subhanAllah, by nature, these people are like that. Attacking nature they have, you know, they're very aggressive in their nature, you know. So, and this is exactly what happened a few years ago, and I'm sure that you went through this video. I saw a group of Ethiopian laborers, you know, in Saudi, in one of the places in Saudi, as a laborers. And something happened, they couldn't get their salary or some bad treatment from the local people or something like that. And they came out of the control, you know, the group of them, they came out in the streets And someone hidden, you know, inside his flat or Allahu alam where, and he's making the you know, the movie out of it. These people, subhanAllah, they are just eating, literally eating, you know, I can say, everyone who's just walking in the street, you know. If any cars, you know, just moves, they will stop the car, they will take the person out, they will break the car, they will burn the car, they will, you know, hit the person. They're just taking out of, you know, all their frustration on these people, you know, breaking, doing all these things. SubhanAllah, so when I saw this video, it's like a 2-3 minutes video, it's chaos. When I saw that, I just remembered this hadith. I said, SubhanAllah, the Prophet ﷺ said, the time will come, the one who will break the Kaaba, he will be from Habasha, which is now Ethiopia. And now these people getting out of their control, you know, and then try to hit and beat people for Allahu alam, what is the reason, you know. So I said, you know, it's not too far for one of them. He will, you know, maybe do something crazy and he will, Allahu alam, that things can get worse and they will reach to Mecca and they will do something like that. They will try to put the ruling and whatsoever upside down. They will try to control the Kaaba, you know, territory and whatsoever. I just thought about it, you know, said, may Allah protect us. After maybe a year, less than a year, I saw another video, and that was, I think, everywhere, you know, that one guy who is bald-headed, you know, and I think he's not wearing anything on top, he was standing on Hajar Ismail, you know, this U Hajar next to the Kaaba, and he is holding a chair and, you know, hitting the lights, one of the lights of the, you saw that?
No
one saw, subhanAllah. It was very, it was just recently. I don't know if you saw this guy, if, that Ethiopian, one Ethiopian guy, black guy. He's bald, you know, topless, and he's holding these small chairs that the Meccan, the authority gives to the people, to the Hajis, to sit and pray. And he is holding, and he is, you know, hitting and breaking the one of the lights at the Hajar Ismail. And when the police guy came, and he literally, you know, he just pushed the police guy, and he was like flying, you know. He went down and it was like big chaos, but alhamdulillah, they control this guy. Mm-hmm. SubhanAllah, it's not too far from happening, you know, that, you know, maybe some other people from his tribe will try to come and do some kind of things. So this is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that a person will come from Habasha, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described him that he is a black guy, bald, thin shins, you know, or thin legs, and this guy will break the Kaaba hajaran hajara, break, you know, into pieces. And this is one of the signs of the hour. May Allah protect us. And this will happen, in future. And this didn't happen yet. Alhamdulillah. So, one of the signs of the hour, I just would like to mention two or three here. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said here in a hadith that you will see the buildings around the Kaaba will be higher than the Kaaba. And no doubt that you saw that, you went to one of these hotels and stayed there. And again, I would like to remind myself and you brothers, it doesn't mean that whatever Prophet ﷺ mentioned about the minor signs are the bad things. It doesn't mean that everything that he mentioned about the minor signs are the bad thing. So the buildings, it's good. It accommodates more people. It can, you can go, you by yourself, you went there, you stayed there for a few days, you went for a Hajj or Umrah or whatsoever. So it's good, it's giving, you know, facilities to the people to come and do the rituals. But it doesn't mean that you are bad and these buildings are bad and you will not stay into these buildings. So this is the meaning of the hadith, that the surrounding of Kaaba, you know, from these buildings, and these buildings will be much taller than the Kaaba by itself. And one of another hadith that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, that the time will come, لَا تَقُمُ السَّاعَ حَتَّى يَلْعَنْ آخِرَ الْأُمَّةَ أَوَّلِهَا. SubhanAllah, that the time will not come until you will find the last people of this nation will curse the first people of this nation. And I believe we also talked about this sign during you know, the first halaqat. This part was joined with another part of the hadith, but here is only this hadith, that the time will not come until you will find people swearing and cursing the people of the first ummah. And I spoke about it, that, you know, now you will find, we have the Rafida, the Shia nowadays that, you know, they will always curse and say things to Sahaba. And we know, we are living in last time, these people saying bad things to the Sahaba, which was the first generation of Islam, you know. And not only that, nowadays people, so-called Muslims, so-called even claiming they are Sunnis, you know, they try to hit the Sahaba. MashaAllah. Assalamu alaikum. Please. So one of the just I'll give you a name because he is now exposed to be a liar. His name is Dr. Adnan Ibrahim. You know, if you listen to him, his talk, he will, subhanAllah, he will. It's like he's making magic upon you. The way he talk, the way he gives you the stories, and the way he gives you the thing, he will make you completely into his speeches and everything. And then he will say, Abu Huraira, he did this, and this Sahabi did this. I don't want to also mention the name, so you will keep in your mind. But he's just mentioning, you know, this Sahabi, and that Sahabi, and he's trying to literally, you know, hit the Sahaba by saying, well, this is not the character of the Sahabi. This Sahabi made a mistake by saying this to Rasulullah. This Sahabi made a mistake by saying or acting or behaving this way to Rasulullah. Nice. So they are, subhanAllah, trying to, you know, hit the first generation of the Sahaba. And this is what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the time will not come until you will find people of this nation, the last people of this nation, will curse the first people of the nation of Islam. And last point, and I would like to just stop here. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in a hadith that also narrated by Ibn Hibban. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, يكون في آخر أمتي رجال يركبون على سرج كأشباه الرحال ينزلون على أبواب المساجد نساؤهم كاسيات عاريات. الله أكبر. Subhanallah, very scary hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the time will come that you will find people will ride upon something look like rihal. Now what is rihal? Rihal is people used to travel from one place to another place. So they, you know, they don't have any transportation. So unless they will use the transportation when they travel, you know. So either now it's a camel or it's a donkey or it's a horse or whatsoever. So they use this kind of thing. So they put their stuff on it and they will, you know, sit on it and then they will move. The Prophet ﷺ said, the time will not come until you see people coming to the masjid using things which is look like rihal. At that time, rihal was what? The camels and the horses and what? Nowadays, that what we ride and go to the masjid, it's something look like these transportation, which is cars, you can say. And anything comes into that category, either it's a motorbike or either it's a scooter, you know, whatsoever, you know that. So, not only that, the Prophet ﷺ, they will come to the masjid and they will come to the door of the masjid. They will just put their feet out from this transportation just next to the masjid. Their women are, you know, kasiyat, ariyat. They are, you know, bad character women, or their women are even not covered, you know. And this word, kasiyat, ariyat, the Prophet ﷺ mentioned in a hadith of Isra al Mi'raj. When the Prophet ﷺ went for, you know, the miraculous journey, Isra al Mi'raj, when he came back, he said, I saw the people in the hellfire, most of them, they are the women. And one of the signs of these women, they are kasiyat, ariyat. They are covered and covered women. So the ulama explained this, the word covered and covered. They are wearing, what so you call it, clothes, but at the end they are not wearing, you know. So it's just a piece, they are putting it into their body, or maybe they are wearing, but it's so tight into their body, so you can see literally their pieces and everything in their body. So this is what the Prophet ﷺ said, that the time will come, the people will ride these cars and these transportation, and they will be so keen to be next to the masjid, and they will, you know, just put their feet from the car and they will enter to the masjid, but you will find their family members, they are kasiyat, ariyat. Wearing but not wearing, you know, and covered but not covered woman. So I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us from you know, all these fitna. And subhanAllah, that's literally, I remember about this hadith. A person came to me actually, and he said, you know, I want you to give me a solution for my sister. I said, what, how can I help you? And wallahi, he told me the same. He said, look, you know, I'm alhamdulillah, I attend to the classes, I go to the mashayikh, I this and that. And he lives, I think, next to the masjid or something like that. But he said, you know, the only problem with my sister, she is uncovered, you know, she doesn't wear hijab. And even the way she wears, you know, the clothes and everything, it's so disgusting that I cannot do anything. I said, okay, just talk to her. You know, you are a brother. You know, you not necessarily you have to beat her and you have to make a big deal out of it. Just talk to her. Say that it's not allowed. He said, well, we are a liberal family. My father will always support her. And she is having this back of her father. I said, well, you just try to give advice. See who's closer to your, you know, sister, either your mother, either your father, whosoever, even through friends or someone if you can reach, and let your sister knows that, you know, this is wrong. So subhanAllah, this is what exactly happened, you know, that this guy is ashamed. He said, I don't know what to do when I leave and when I'm standing outside the masjid, people see my sister, you know, she's not covered. And the way she wears and the way she put the perfume and whatsoever. But so I'm saying, this is the fact, this is happening. So I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy upon all of us and upon the ummah of Islam. Jazakumullah khair. And the next sign of the hour is Zuhur al-Mahdi, which is, you know, appearing of the Mahdi. And this is by itself, it's a big topic. And in it, there is a lot of sub stories and subtitles. So inshallah, we will get through all this by next halaqa or any other weeks inshallah. And if you have any comments, if you have anything you would like to say, please feel free to say. Jazakumullah khair. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.